He who wishes to be rich in a day will be hanged in a year. Leonardo da Vinci. My friends, there are no shortcuts. There is a little work each and every day. All we ask is 10 to 15 minutes to learn the nuances of the ETFs and stocks you're interested in. Yes, what we teach you can be applied to stocks if they are chartable. We have a great training for you today. I was just listening to it and am really proud of it. We put it out a while back, but again, it is a good one. It's called Have a Plan Before Pulling the Trigger. It talks about making sure you know what your loss limits are before you enter a trade. Have a reason for doing it. Fill out your trade worksheets that are available every day in your show notes. If you're not a subscriber, go to chartingwealth.com and sign up for free. Every day you will get the recording that we do, the video, plus you'll get the daily market worksheet, trade worksheet, weekly market worksheet, the special training we put out on a daily basis, everything you need at no cost to you to start figuring out how to do this. You want to buy our book? That'd be great. You want to be a Patreon supporter? That would be great. By the way, Patreon supporters, check your emails. We sent you 10 potential weekly vertical crossovers yesterday going up and 10 weekly vertical crossovers going down. You can pick and choose from those to practice trade this Friday. So look at them, do some backtracking, do some practice trading. Get ready to jump in the market potentially tomorrow around 345, 350 if those weekly vertical crossovers continue to push through. That's one of the benefits you get as a Patreon member. Check us out. We appreciate the Patreon support. The lowest level is $30 a month. That's a dollar a day. We appreciate the help. Now, let's jump into these charts. We see the S&P 500, the NASDAQ 100. We see 20-year bonds, and we see gold, all of them up over 1%. The only thing down, Bitcoin. Let's jump first into the lowest gainer for the day, but that was even 1.07%. That's the S&P 500. Remember that weekly vertical crossover we had last week? Somewhere around the 407 mark. How high have we gotten this week? Up to 416, a little over that. So, price percent oscillator pulling away from the red signal line. Derivative oscillator gaining upward momentum. Price heading up, looking nice. Today, again, check it out. First day of the latest two-day candle moving right up. Is that not a beautiful trend line that you see and things just climbing right up it? It is quite beautiful. Price percent oscillator heading up. Derivative oscillator heading up. Half-day chart. It's interesting. It crossed over going down in the afternoon on Wednesday. And then, let's see, has it reverted over? It has, slowly but surely. It managed to plod through that throughout the day. So the half-day is heading up. And again, price well above the weekly, well above the two-day also. Things are looking good. All right. Now let's move from the S&P to the NASDAQ 100 up 1.52%. Quite a gainer. Are we going to have a weekly vertical crossover on Friday? Don't know. Don't know. Right now, not quite there. It may happen. So mark that. Watch it. Pay attention to it. I'm not going to be sending out a notice to you because it's not happening yet. Could it happen? It could. But it has not crossed over at this point. I'm not going to fire off the text messaging service on this right now. Do watch it. If it does cross over, then of course be ready for it. Put it on your daily market worksheet today. Go ahead. Set an alarm on your phone. This is how I do it. When I know there are things, I put them on my calendar. I set the alarm on my phone. It goes off at 3:30, tells me I got 15 minutes to get to a computer and be ready. I do that. I sit down. I start looking things over, seeing what looks to be crossing, how strong they are. What does the two-day look like? What does the half-day look like? How strong is that weekly crossover? Have I backtracked it? Well, how has it performed in the past? Look at my trader's journal, my notebook, to see what my past trades were like. All those kinds of things. In fact, I do that in advance of 3:30. But I start bringing all that stuff back up and into my mind before it's too late, before you're scrambling around at 3:58, making a dumb move and entering into a bad trade. So again, you're going to practice trade this. At some point, you'll fractional trade it, which means putting a little bit of real money in, maybe $50 or $100. And again, seeing how well you can do with real money. That's what we do. That's how we practice. That's how we get good. How do you get to Carnegie Hall? Practice. So we see the Q's not yet crossing over. Derivative oscillator still negative. Price percent oscillator getting closer. May cross over by the end of the day on Friday. What do we see on the two-day chart? Moving up quite nicely. Price percent oscillator heading up. Derivative oscillator moving up, reaching a higher high. Candle's getting a little smaller, but again, that's just the first day of the latest two-day. What about the half-day? Still negative. It did move up in the morning and the afternoon, but didn't cross over yet. Derivative oscillator gaining downward momentum. That's coming from that punch down on Wednesday. So that's as far as the derivative oscillator oscillating down goes. Takes it a while. It's a leading indicator. It's a triple smooth version of the relative strength index. So it's showing that weakness in strength. We'll see how it recovers. Not so worried about the half day, paying close attention to that weekly and the 2 day. Those are the bigger waves, the biggest being the weekly. That's why it's the most powerful. That's the one we primarily want to practice trade off of. Let's leave stocks, go to bonds. Bonds up nicely. The highest gainer for the day of our four charts is TLT. That's 20-year plus government bonds, up 1.67%. And look how we've seen the candles just grow in magnitude, going from a green spinning top, means a slowdown in the down movement, more to a doji, then to a doji, and now a green up candle. Well, it wasn't quite a doji as we move in. You can see it was a little bit it's the line's messing it up, but it is a bit of a green open box spinning top there. Then, of course, we've got the green open box candle that is forming for this week. Haven't had a crossover yet, unless it's a crazy up day tomorrow. Probably isn't going to happen this week, but we'll continue to watch. Derivative oscillator still negative, losing downward momentum. Price percent oscillator negative heading up. That's on the weekly 2 day, popping up quite nicely. Derivative oscillator heading up, price percent oscillator heading up, half day. See where it popped up in the morning, and about the same in the afternoon as far as the high goes, a little bit higher, and of course that candle going up. Nice to see. Maybe bonds are bottoming out. We'll wait. We'll see if we get that crossover. Now look at gold on the weekly chart. Gold has been sliding sideways last 2 weeks, starting to move up. Price percent oscillator getting closer to crossing over. Derivative oscillator heading up. I want gold to cross, my friends. I want to get back into gold. I hope you're looking forward to some big practice trades on gold. If we can get that momentum to be sustained. Price percent oscillator still negative, but heading up. Derivative oscillator negative, losing downward momentum. Price percent oscillator on the two-day chart heading up. Derivative oscillator heading up. Things are looking nice, so we'll continue to watch and see how that two-day candle ends up on Friday. And of course, we see where the price percent oscillator flipped over, going up in the morning on Thursday and hitting about that same high in the afternoon in gold. Price above the two-day, looking nice. So again, hoping for, in the not-too-distant future, a weekly vertical crossover going up on gold, same on bonds, waiting to see what's going to happen on the Qs on Friday if we're going to have a weekly vertical crossover there. And the weekly vertical crossover occurred at the end of last week on the 9th. That was Friday the 9th, representing that entire week. We had that weekly vertical crossover, and we've seen a nice up week since then. Lastly, we go to Bitcoin. It was only downer for the day. It was down 0.73%. We have a green up candle for the week. Price percent oscillator, still negative. Derivative oscillator, losing a little bit of downward momentum, but still negative. Now, big news in Bitcoin is, of course, it did push through the $60,000 mark that's hovering around right now, all the way up to $63,247.81. We look at the two-day chart. It's flat on the price percent oscillator. Derivative oscillator's already gone positive, and we're hitting about the same point that we hit before when we're looking at that candle. Again, like we said, it's down a little bit for the day, but 0.73%, you know, 0.75%, not much for Bitcoin, the way it moves. You can see, though, on the half-day chart, how things have sort of topped off and weakened. That's where we are as we look at our four big charts and Bitcoin. Thank you, my friends. God bless. Hope you're filling out your daily market worksheet. It will supercharge your training along with that trade worksheet. And of course, at the close of the market tomorrow, we'll be recording the weekly review and forecast. And that is when you listen to it that you fill out your weekly market worksheet. You don't have our book, we have an autographed copy waiting for you. God bless. All the best from the whole team at Charting Wealth, World Headquarters.